Hello. In this video, we will understand about the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium principle of evolution chapter. Hardy and Weinberg, they both given a principle which explains about the allelic frequency and how this allelic frequency changes leads to evolution. And how it is responsible for evolution, they explain with the help of a principle that is called equilibrium principle. And this Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium principle says that the allelic frequency, it is also called gene pool. And how this allelic frequency is defined, very simple, the totality of all the genes and alleles in the population, the entire population present in the geographical region, surviving in the geographical region, the totality of all the genes and alleles is called gene pool, which we consider it allelic frequency. We consider it as allelic frequency, and that allelic frequency remains constant. It will remain constant and stable over the generations to generations, in the absence of disturbing factors, in the absence of any particular deviating or disturbing factors. The allelic frequency or gene pool frequency remains to be stable or same over the generations, and it remains constant always. So that is equilibrium principle. Equilibrium principle always said to be in equilibrium condition. So let's say the dominant allele, imagine a dominant allele is capital A and a recessive allele is small a. So this is dominant and this is recessive allele. And let's say the frequencies of these alleles are, the frequencies are P and Q respectively. P and Q. The P and Q are the frequencies of this dominant and recessive alleles respectively. Let's say P is a frequency of dominant allele capital A, and Q is the frequency of recessive allele small a. So like that it will be indicated. And homozygous dominant condition. Let's take homozygous dominant condition. That means capital A. Alright? Capital A. That means P square. The frequency of homozygous dominant condition is P square. Next, homozygous recessive condition. Let's take this. Recessive allele is small a. So, small a. That means Q square. And whereas heterozygous means capital A small a, that means 2pq. And now the total frequency, so p plus q whole square is equal to p square plus 2pq plus q square. So it remains 1. That means the result is 1. So the equilibrium condition will be maintained or established due to the absence of any kind of disturbing factors that deviates this equilibrium. Okay. So let's take one example, and based on these examples, you may get one MCQ in the NEET examination. This is very, very important concept. Let's take a population of beetles in one geographical region. Let's take a population of beetles in a geographical region. So I'm taking homozygous dominant first. I'm writing homozygous dominant. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. These all are homozygous dominant individuals. Homozygous dominant individuals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Homozygous dominant. Let's take some heterozygous individuals also. Heterozygous individuals. A few are heterozygous individuals I'm taking now. Okay, let's take six heterozygous individuals. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. And then, homozygous recessive also I'm taking. Okay, these are homozygous recessive. So 17, 18, 19, and 20. So total population is 20. That means total genotypes. Total population means total genotypes is how much? 20. And total number of alleles, how much? Total number of alleles. 20 individuals, 20 into 2 alleles, so 40. So 20 into 2, 40. Got it. Okay, now we will find out the genotypic frequency and allelic frequency. First, dominant, homozygous dominant genotype frequency. Homozygous dominant genotype frequency. How many homozygous dominant? 10. 10 are there. That means frequency 10 by, out of total number of genotypes, how much? 20. So 10 by 20 is 0.5. Next, second one. Homozygous recessive genotype frequency. Recessive genotype frequency. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 out of 20. So 4 by 20, that means 0.2 itself. Next, number 3. Heterozygous dominant genotype frequency. Heterozygous dominant means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 out of 20. 0.3. And if you count the totality of all these genotypes, homozygous dominant, homozygous recessive, heterozygous dominant. Totality you consider 0.5 plus 0.2 plus 0.3 is 1. So again, we are getting 1. That equilibrium condition, 1 we are getting. Next, allelic frequency we consider. Allelic frequency. Total number of alleles, how much? 40. In this dominant allelic frequency, how much? Here 10 already homozygous dominant are there. So 20. 21. This is 21. This is 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So dominant allele frequency. Dominant allele frequency. 26 by 40. So we get 0.65 approximately. And then recessive allele frequency will count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4 into 2, 8. So 6 plus 8, 14. Recessive allele frequency. Recessive allele number, how much? 14. And frequency means 14 by 40. Out of 40, recessive alleles are only 14. So we'll get approximately 0.35. Then the totality will be again, right? 1 only. So both you consider 1 and 1, equilibrium condition. So this explains the equilibrium in a population over the generations in the absence of disturbing factors. So hope you all understood this principle. So Hattie Weinberg explained that the allelic frequency in a population remains stable from generation to generation in the absence of disturbing factors. Let's take the dominant allele as capital A and recessive allele as small a, and P is dominant allele frequency, and Q is recessive allele frequency, and it results in P square plus 2BQ plus Q square equal to P plus Q whole square. That remains one, that is equilibrium condition. And then we took one example of beetles, population of beetles in a geographical region, and we took the dominant and heterozygous dominant, and then homozygous recessive, and genotypic frequency as well as allelic frequency we calculated. You will get one MCQ based on this genotype and allelic frequency calculation. So hope you understood. Thank you very much.